believe in a generous America. To the young boy on the south side of Chicago who sees a life beyond the nearest street corner. That's the future we hope for.
Tonight I'm gonna liberate you, I'm gonna motivate you. You didn't go through a year fail so that you could be positioned for that next level of greatness. Look, it's now or never, but guess what? The never, never matters.
Despite what's happening, I'm still getting over the hump every single day. Stop sitting on your butt. Get up, get out, go get some. I'm telling you now, don't expect to be made overnight. It's not gonna happen.
I'm getting over hurt. I'm getting over rejection. I'm getting over pain. Let's go. We're getting over the hump. What up, world? It's your man, Richard Taylor. Welcome to another episode of Getting Over the Hump. I am excited. Why? Because greatness is here. Greatness is upon me. Greatness is upon you. Greatness is upon us. Look, last week we talked about dead weight, and I kind of broke it down about the whole dead weight, about what you need to do to shed off that dead weight in your life. So this week, look, I'm taking you to a point of failure. If you look behind me, this field behind me, I played football when I was in high school. Thought ball was my life. Ball is life, like everybody say. I thought ball was my destiny. I thought it was my life. I had a heart condition though. Had to stop playing football, right? So once I stopped playing, I started to get into this mindset and this mode of failure. I felt like a failure in my work. I felt like a failure in everything I did. I started being real lackadaisical in my actions. I would go to class every day feeling like a failure. I wouldn't put in the work that I needed to put in class. I felt like everything that I put my hard work into, everything that I put my heart into, I could never complete it. And I kid you not, this is where a lot of us are at times, right? Because we're going out here, we're chasing our dream, we're chasing our passion. And what happens when we chasing, right? Sometimes we don't see it the way that we expect to. And what happens? You start to feel like a failure. You start to question yourself. You start to wonder, is this for me? Why am I even doing this? Why am I putting so much time into something and not seeing a return on my investment? There are two things I want you to understand. And the first one that you need to know is how to fail. How do I fail? There are two routes of failure that you can take. You can passively fail and you can aggressively fail. When I say you passively fail, do you sit back in self-pity? Do you sit back upset at the world? Do you sit back mad at yourself, soaking in your fear, soaking in your doubt, soaking in your words, in your disbelief? Or will you aggressively fail? Les Brown said it best. If you get knocked down and you can look up, then get up. And I'm telling you now, if you get knocked down, if you get rejected, will you look up, will you get up, and will you keep going? Because you look at some of the greats out here now, you look at some of the billionaires in the world, you look at some of the biggest people in our time, they failed their way to the top. They failed their way to success until they finally figured out where they failed. And the next time the test came around, this is why I love the test, because every time the test comes back around, you have a new opportunity to get it right. You have a new opportunity to go back and look and say, okay, let me take a step back, strategize, see what I did wrong, and execute the next time. I told you before, innovation is rewarded, execution is worship. We got that from my man Eric Thomas, and I'm starting to understand exactly what he meant now. When you can get back up, when you see your failure, when you see the spot that you failed, you can get back up. You know exactly what you need to do or what you need not to do. That way, when the test comes back around, boom, execution. Execution is there. People ask me all the time, what gives you the right? What allows you to do what you do at 24? Because I lived it, because I went through it, because I failed. And I'm still failing now, but I'm telling you now, the difference in my failure now at 24 compared to when I was failing at 18, 19 is the fact that now I'm failing, and I'm failing aggressively. I'm getting back up. I'm getting back in line and I'm pushing again. So I'm telling you now, you make the decision today. Do I fail passively? Do I sit back and let my life go on? Or do I fail aggressively? And every time I fail, I get up and I get better. It's up to you today. Look, that's it. That's my message. Look, are you getting over the hump? You need to ask yourself that. How are you getting over the hump? And am I getting over the hump? Failure is not an option. But if it is, if failure has to be an option for you, fail aggressively, fail hard, get up and keep going. It's your man, Richard Taylor. I'll see you next week.